Welcome to our service at Evensong. From St. Mary's, the parish church of Westonbirt with Lasborough. You are very welcome from wherever you are viewing us this evening, whether it be from the benefice or beyond. My thanks go to Bishop Robert, who will be preaching for us this evening, and our readers, Geoff Fitch and Mark Winston-Davis. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you for this opportunity to worship you. In Jesus' name. Amen. When the wicked man turneth away from his wickedness that he hath committed, and doeth that which is lawful and right, he shall save his soul alive. The sacrifices of God are a broken spirit, a broken and a contrite heart, O God, thou wilt not despise. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins,
He is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Dearly beloved brethren, the scripture moveth us in sundry places to acknowledge and confess our manifold sins and wickedness, and that we should not dissemble nor cloak them before the face of Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, but confess them with a humble, lowly, penitent, and obedient heart, to the end that we may obtain forgiveness of the same by his infinite goodness and mercy. And although we ought at all times humbly to acknowledge our sins before God, yet ought we most chiefly so to do when we assemble and meet together to render thanks for the great benefits that we have received at his hands, to set forth his most worthy praise, to hear his most holy word, and to ask those things which are requisite and necessary as well for the body as the soul. Wherefore I pray and beseech you, as many as are here present, to accompany me with a pure heart and a humble voice unto the throne of the heavenly grace, saying after me, Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from thy ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against thy holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And there is no health in us, but thou, O Lord, have mercy upon us, miserable offenders. Spare thou them, O God, which confess their faults. Restore thou them that are penitent, according to thy promises declared unto mankind, in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may hereafter live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of thy holy name. Amen. Grant, we beseech thee, merciful Lord, to thy faithful people pardon and peace, that they may be cleansed from all their sins and serve thee with a quiet mind through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
O Lord, open thou our lips,
and our mouth shall show forth thy praise.
O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Praise ye the Lord.
The Lord's name be praised.
I am well pleased that the Lord hath heard the voice of my prayer. I believed, and therefore will I speak. But I was sore troubled. I said in my haste, all men are liars. What reward shall I give unto the Lord for all the benefits that he hath done unto me? I will receive the cup of salvation and call upon the name of the Lord. I will pay my vows now in the presence of all his people. Right dear in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. Behold, O Lord, how that I am thy servant. I am thy servant and the son of thine handmaid. Thou hast broken my bonds in sunder. I will offer to thee the sacrifice of thanksgiving and will call upon the name of the Lord. I will pay my vows unto the Lord in the sight of all his people. In the courts of the Lord's house, even in the midst of thee, O Jerusalem, praise the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
This lesson is St. Paul's Epistle to the Romans, chapter 5, starting at verse 1. Therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom also we have access by faith into this grace wherein we stand, and rejoice in hope of the glory of God. And not only so, but we glory in tribulations also, knowing that tribulation worketh patience, and patience experience, and experience hope. And hope maketh not ashamed, because the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost, which is given unto us. For when we were yet without strength, in due time Christ died for the ungodly. For scarcely was a righteous man will one die, yet peradventure for a good man some would even dare to die. But God commandeth his love toward us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Here endeth this lesson.
We say the Magnificat together. My soul doth magnify the Lord, and my spirit hath rejoiced in God my Saviour, for he hath regarded the lowliness of his handmaiden. For behold, from henceforth all generations shall call me blessed, for he that is mighty hath magnified me, and holy is his name. And his mercy is on them that fear him throughout all generations. He hath showed strength with his arm. He hath scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He hath put down the mighty from their seat, and hath exalted the humble and meek. He hath filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he hath sent empty away. He, remembering his mercy, hath holpen his servant Israel, as he promised to our forefathers, Abraham and his seed for ever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
This reading is taken from Matthew 9, verses 35 to 38, and Matthew 10, verses 1 to 8. And Jesus went about all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues and preaching the gospel of the kingdom and healing every disease and every infirmity. When he saw the crowds, he had compassion for them, because they were harassed and helpless, like sheep without a shepherd. Then he said to his disciples, "The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Pray, therefore, the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest." And he called to him his 12 disciples and gave them authority over unclean spirits to cast them out and to heal every disease and every infirmity. The names of the 12 apostles are these. First, Simon, who is called Peter, and Andrew his brother, James, the son of Zebedee, and John his brother, Philip and Bartholomew, Thomas and Matthew, the tax collector, James, the son of Alphaeus and Thaddeus, Simon the Canaan, and Judas Iscariot, who betrayed him. These 12 Jesus sent out, charging them, "Go nowhere amongst the Gentiles and enter no town of the Samaritans, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel, and preach as you go, saying, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Heal the sick, raise the dead, cleanse the lepers, cast out demons. You received without paying, give without pay." Here ends the lesson.
Lord, now lettest thou thy servant depart in peace, according to thy word, for mine eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all people, to be a light to lighten the Gentiles, and to be the glory of thy people Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you, and with thy spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
O Lord, show thy mercy upon us,
and grant us thy salvation.
O Lord, save the Queen,
and mercifully hear us when we call upon thee.
Endue thy ministers with righteousness,
and make thy chosen people joyful.
O Lord, save thy people,
and bless thine inheritance.
Give peace in our time, O Lord,
because there is none other that fighteth for us, but only thou, O God.
God, may clean our hearts within us,
and take not thy Holy Spirit from us.
O God, the strength of all those who put their trust in you, mercifully accept our prayers, and because through the weakness of our mortal nature, we can do no good thing without you, Grant us the help of your grace, that in the keeping of your commandments we may please you both in will and deed, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servant that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee, we being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ, our Saviour. Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thy only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen. O Lord, our Heavenly Father, high and mighty, King of kings, Lord of lords, the only ruler of princes, who dost from thy throne behold all the dwellers upon earth. Most heartily we beseech thee, with thy favour, to behold our most gracious Sovereign Lady, Queen Elizabeth, and so replenish her with the grace of thy Holy Spirit, that she may alway incline to thy will and walk in thy way. Endue her plenteously with heavenly gifts. Grant her in health and wealth long to live. Strengthen her that she may vanquish and overcome all her enemies. And finally, after this life, she may attain everlasting joy and felicity through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, the fountain of all goodness, we humbly beseech thee to bless Philip, Duke of Edinburgh, Charles, Prince of Wales, and all the royal family. Endue them with thy Holy Spirit, enrich them with thy heavenly grace, prosper them with all happiness, and bring them to thine everlasting kingdom, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty and everlasting God, who alone workest great marvels, send down upon our bishops and curates and all congregations committed to their charge the healthful spirit of thy grace, and that they may truly please thee, pour upon them the continual dew of thy blessing. Grant this, O Lord, for the honour of our advocate and mediator, Jesus Christ. Amen. In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. We pray for the world, created by your love, for its nations and governments. We pray for our Prime Minister, Boris Johnson, and Her Majesty's government. Extend to them your peace, pardoning love, mercy, and grace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the Church, created for your glory, for its ministry to reflect those works of yours. We pray for the worldwide Anglican Church, and this day for the Anglican Church in Myanmar, Burma, and Archbishop Stephen. We pray for our own five overseas partner dioceses, especially the Diocese of Vastaras and Bishop Mikael. And we pray for Bishop Rachel and Bishop Robert, our own Diocese of Gloucester, and all the churches and people in our benefice. We pray for our schools in Acton Turville, Hawkesbury, and Laterton. Extend to us your salvation, growth, mercy, and grace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for families and individuals created in your image, for the lonely, the bereaved, the sick, and the dying. We pray for ourselves, and we continue to pray for the NHS. And we name anyone known to us who needs our prayers before you in stillness and peace. Breathe on them the breath of life and bring them to your mercy and grace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for anyone known to us who has recently died. Graham Baker. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them, and may the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Bring us all to bow before your throne in heaven, to receive life and pardon, mercy and grace for all eternity, now and forever. Amen. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
In the name of the living God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. It's so good to be with you this morning. I was last in the benefice at Hawkesbury just after Christmas when there was snow and ice on the road. And my goodness, the world has changed since then, all that we have lived through. Today I was to be at Laterton and Lasborough. Instead, I'm joining you from my home. I'm sure that you, like me, will have been sad to know that Richard, your parish priest, has not been well, not thankfully with COVID. He's back home now and recovering, but rightly signed off. And I'm sure that you will join with me in assuring him of our prayers and our good wishes. Well, our buildings may have been closed these last few weeks, but the church most certainly has not. We've completed our observance of the great events of the church's year, the creation of the birth of Christ at Christmas, of Jesus's life and ministry. We've lived through Holy Week, followed Jesus to the cross, to the tomb, and then to the joy of Easter morning of the resurrection. We've celebrated Ascension and Pentecost, and just last Sunday, the Feast of the Trinity. And now our liturgical colours, purple, white, gold, red, turn to green as we get on with the business of life in this Trinity season that we begin this Sunday. Trinity season, sometimes called ordinary time. For us, perhaps this change to ordinary time comes with the realisation that we're going to have to live this time for quite a while to come. This time with uncertainty, with anxiety. Among people who are not quite sure of what the future is going to be like for them, for those they love, for the communities in which they live. It's not dissimilar from the situation that Jesus faced in our gospel this morning as he goes about the cities and the villages, meeting the crowds who have no one to look after them, no one to care for them, no shepherd. Jesus sees them, he loves them, his compassion goes out to them, and he urges his disciples to pray for labourers to be sent out into the harvest. And then an extraordinary thing happens. The disciples become the answer to their own prayer as they are given authority by Jesus and sent out themselves to proclaim the good news of the kingdom. Rather beautifully, we get their names: Simon, known as Peter, Andrew, James, John, Philip, Judas, and so on. They're, of course, an imperfect lot, including betrayers and zealots. They're probably not that easy company. But they are the ones that Jesus chooses and uses, sent to show his compassion to the world. A people with a particular care for those on the edge of society, for those on the edge of life. They are the answer to their own prayer, and we are that answer also. Jesus looks out on our world today and in his divine compassion sees the needs of all around us, sees our needs, sees the needs of those who suffer, those who are isolated, sees the needs of the lonely, sees the needs of those who are oppressed by the evils of racism, of social isolation. Jesus looks at the mess of our life and our world with that deep compassion and asks us to be signs, to be purveyors of his love, that love which is Christ's way. Jesus asks us to put self aside and to act with humanity, with generosity, with dignity, to be agents of compassion, that compassion which is above all his mark. Jesus calls us by name as he called those first disciples and sends us out in service to proclaim that the kingdom of heaven is near, not just for the people like us, but for all, especially those closest to his heart, the meek, the oppressed, those who mourn, who hunger, who thirst. We, you and I, are called to be people of the Beatitudes, people who bring Christ's good news, Christ's blessing in the ordinary, as we get on with the ordinary business of life. So here's my question for you this week. How will we hear and respond to Christ's call to us? How will we make that prayer that labourers may be sent to the harvest? And how will we answer it in our own lives? How will we be Jesus' compassion? How will we bless in Jesus' name in the midst of the ordinary, that we, that all may experience the extraordinary power of Christ's love? Amen.
Almighty God, who has given us grace at this time, with one accord to make our common supplications unto thee, and is promised that when two or three are gathered together in thy name, thou wilt grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, the desires and petitions of thy servants, as may be most expedient for them, granting us in this world knowledge of thy truth, and in the world to come, life everlasting. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with us all, evermore. Amen.